Thanksgiving is coming up, and there's no better way to celebrate the harvest and blessings of the preceding year than shoving food in a bird's ass, no? So, Thanksgiving is mainly a North American tradition where families get together and gather around the dinner table and spread gratitude. And there's one absolutely necessary item in order for people to do so. Turkey. Oh, but dead turkey, which is the traditional centerpiece for Thanksgiving dinner. We even call it Turkey Day. Now, what is turkey? Turkey is a species of bird that is native to North America. And every November, the US president pardons a turkey, and the rest of them sacrifice their lives for humans for the annual ritual, which is about gratitude. Now, why? Why do they do that? Well, humans say it's what they've been doing for a very long time. It is a tradition. Well, that's so interesting, right? But all of it makes sense when we know what they truly mean. It's not the turkey's tradition, but their tradition, the humans. Okay, so now to me, it's starting to sound like something. Yulin Dog Meat Festival. It's an annual festival in Yulin, Guangxi, China, where people kill thousands of dogs and cats, get together and gather around dinner tables, cook and eat the animals and have fun. But okay, maybe this is an unfair comparison. Maybe Thanksgiving is much worse than Yulin in terms of the number of victims. So while people in Yulin kill thousands, or over 10,000 dogs for the festival that lasts 10 days every year, according to the National Turkey Federation, over 45 million turkeys are killed in the United States every year just for the Thanksgiving Day alone. Now you might say this isn't fair because the comparison isn't taking in the populations of humans that are involved in those events into account. But I don't think it's that important of a factor when we talk about the scale of suffering a single festival or holiday as an idea causes. Okay, but hold on, wouldn't it be okay if we raise and kill the turkeys in the most humane and quickest way possible? I mean, look at Yulin. There's obvious animal abuse and cruelty involved. Well, so the question becomes, how are the commercial turkeys farmed and killed? Well, turkeys have been selectively bred to grow abnormally large very quickly. Today, on average, turkeys weigh more than twice as much than they did in 1960. At this rate, the average weight in 2020 could be as high as 40 pounds. And on top of that, they reach the size in half the natural time. So, to put that in perspective, the human equivalent would be weighing about 300 pounds by the age of 10. This severely damages their bodies. Many suffer from heart attacks, and because of this, turkeys are so mutated and aren't able to naturally reproduce. So farmers artificially breed all commercial turkeys today by jerking male turkeys off, sucking their semen with a straw, and inserting it into female turkeys against their will. Babies are de-beaked and de-toed with heated blades. This painful mutilation is intended to prevent them from injuring each other, from the stress from being confined in a crowd, and not being able to express their natural behavior. And as injured ones and those who don't meet the industry standards are considered not profitable, they are either crushed and discarded along with the eggshells, thrown into a plastic bag to suffocate to death, or thrown into a mass blender where they're ground up alive, fully conscious. And the turkeys spend their entire lives being confined in a dark, crowded, ammonia-filled barn without adequate sunlight or fresh air. Abuse and violence are prevalent in every farm PETA investigated. Inside farms that advertise humane treatment of turkeys, farmers apparently have a very loose definition of humane. They treat the animals as if they are objects and even often intentionally injure them to the point where they can't stand up to defend themselves, but instead suffer on the ground and die. Wild turkeys live for around 10 years, but most of the domestic turkeys are slaughtered in the first 5th month of their lives, which means they get to live for only 4% of their natural lifespan. They're loaded onto trucks and sent to the slaughterhouse as babies, hung upside down on a slaughter line, and are forced to drown in an electrified water bath and have their necks slit open. These methods don't always kill the turkeys, so many of them are still conscious when they're dragged through the massive tank of boiling water and they're scalded alive. So, if you think this is cruel enough, according to the USDA, the Humane Methods of Slaughter Act does not even apply to chickens or other birds, so poultry in general, which of course includes turkeys. So anything can legally happen inside those facilities, no one is held accountable for it, and nothing will stop it. So after going through all of these, the turkeys then arrive at the supermarkets, wrapped in packages and labels saying that they lived a happy life, a life free of cages, and that they were humanely raised so that we can cook them without appreciating or even imagining what they went through for us. And then they're put in the ovens and arrive at the dinner tables in our warm homes. And finally, we concentrate that individual suffering in what we call gravy and pour it onto our food and, of course, give our beloved dog some bites of it. So yes, this is the essential ingredient and recipe for us humans to express how thankful we are. But why? Why does it have to be turkey causing all of that suffering? The very fascinating answer is that we don't know. No one really knows why we eat turkey for Thanksgiving. Despite how significant of a piece it is, it's been debated. It's still a mystery, meaning pretty much the only reason we do so is solely because of the fact that it is traditional and because everyone else around is doing it. We are all taught to do it. There's really no other explanation for it. It's the work of the herd mentality. Needless to say, it is the same reason people in Yulin kill dogs for their festival. And ironically, it is the exact same reason why many of us in the West or outside China stand up against the festival while eating turkey on Thanksgiving Day or Christmas. Because we grew up in a society where dogs and cats are meant to be adored by humans. So, although we don't know why we eat turkey, what we know is that just because something is cultural or traditional doesn't mean it is ethical. It is not a valid or good enough justification for us to use to take the life of an innocent, sentient being. Because it is unnecessary, we say Thanksgiving Day is a good day to recommit our energies to giving thanks and just giving. But we have forgotten that it is also a day to take tens of millions of innocent lives needlessly. And because the tradition that is centered around family and food is held at the expense of someone else having their family torn apart and their lives taken, maybe a more appropriate word for the day is sorry. But can we apologize enough? Let's not forget, true forgiveness is when you can say thank you for that experience. When we make the connection, we know that not all cultures and traditions are meant to continue to be appreciated, but they can still be with a simple switch. A few days ago, I made fully plant-based Thanksgiving seitan roast along with the most flavorful vegan gravy and some classic side dishes. And with delicious dishes like this, we can give thanks and spread gratitude without harming a turkey and other animals while still appreciating and embracing the culture and tradition we grew up with our families. So, for this coming Thanksgiving and beyond, which are you going to choose? Are you going to choose to blindfold yourself, even though you now know the truth, and be stuck with the tradition of needless mass murdering? Or are you going to choose to help those who don't have a choice, and celebrate the true essence of the holiday and tradition? It is up to you. I wish all of you a happy Thanksgiving.